Summary of Book Second. This division, embracing the latter 80 years of the 17th century, contains the close of our early poetical style and the commencement of the modern. In Dryden, we see the first master of the new, in Milton, whose genius dominates here, as Shakespeare's in the former book, the crown and consummation of the early period. Their splendid odes are far in advance of any prior attempts, Spenser's excepted. They exhibit the wider and grander range which years and experience and the struggles of the time conferred on poetry. Our muses now give expression to political feeling, to religious thought, to a high philosophic statesmanship in writers such as Marvell, Herbert, and Wotton. Whilst in Marvell and Milton again we find the first noble attempts at pure description of nature, destined in our own ages to be continued and equaled. Meanwhile, the poetry of simple passion, although before 1660 often deformed by verbal fancies and conceits of thought, and afterward by levity and an artificial tone, produced in Herrick and Waller some charming pieces of more finished art than the Elizabethan. Until, in the courtly compliments of Sidley, it seems to exhaust itself and lie almost dormant for the 100 years between the days of Wither and Suckling and the days of Burns and Cowper. That the change from our early style to the modern brought with it, at first a loss of nature and simplicity, is undeniable. Yet the far bolder and wider scope which poetry took between 1620 and 1700, and the successful efforts then made to gain greater clearness in expression, in their results have been no slight compensation.